This is Roosevelt Giss with AutoNetwork, and we're here in San Francisco with Mitsubishi for the launch of the new Mitsubishi Outlander. My guest on the show today is Dan Sims, the General Manager of the Design Center. Dan, thanks for taking the time.
Thank you. My pleasure.
What kind of challenges did you have to come up with, I guess, a redesign, a definitely refreshing of this new Outlander over the old one versus what the competition has in the marketplace?
Yeah, one of the things that we saw coming was that this small compact SUV market is going to be really booming. And a lot of our competitors are entering that market. And so the vehicle really had to be good. So not only did we have to outperform our current vehicle, but we needed to offer some great performance features that our competitors wouldn't have as well. So we kind of had to anticipate where they were going.
Now, you went to an aluminum roof.
That's correct.
Tell us a little bit more why you went with aluminum, but I'm more interested in the repair factor.
Well, actually, one of the reasons we went with the aluminum roof was this is really a different kind of an SUV. This is a driver-oriented SUV, and really one of the important factors of this is it really had to handle and perform well. And one of the things that was learned from the development of the Evolution MR, the Lancer Evolution MR, was that an aluminum roof lightens the car up high quite a bit, about 11 pounds. And what it does is it lowers the center of gravity quite a bit to offer a lot less rolling when the car is going around cornering. So you get a lot better stable cornering conditions and a lot better handling dynamics.
Now, you have a third row seat and it's not the same size as the other row seat. Why did you decide to go with a third row and have such a small seating situation?
Well, that's something that's really interesting. A lot of our customers were really asking for that, even if it's a relatively small seat. And so the way it's set up in the Outlander is it's there for kind of like small children. It's like a jump seat in the back. So that if, for example, your parents are visiting or something and you want to go with your kids, they can jump in the very back. But it allows a lot of flexibility that the current Outlander doesn't have. So not only can you seat five adults, but you can also carry two children as well.
Now you have some nice technology in there. You have the Fosgate sound system, you have a hard drive where you can actually load music, but you don't have an iPod or MP3 jack. How could you do that?
Well, no, that's coming. That's definitely on the road. It's coming. And that was partly due to the bus system, the way the unit communicates with the rest of the vehicle. But that's something that Mitsubishi is aware of, and we're bringing that to market very soon.
Now, what's going to be the demographics in terms of breakdown between male and female?
I think you're going to find a pretty 50-50 breakup. You're going to find a lot of young families. Really, this is a kind of a car that can meet the life needs of a lot of different kind of customers. So you can have like young single people who have a very active lifestyle. They need to haul around their toys. They want to go around with their friends. Or you can have a young married couple that has young children. It's very good for commuting and taking the kids to school and then also doing recreational things on the weekend. And then I think what you're going to find too is a lot of empty nesters, people who have had the big SUV and their kids have grown up and have moved out of the house, and they really like the flexibility of an SUV, but they don't want to be paying the big gas prices and dealing with mileage and the big size. And so it's a good all-around size. And the flexibility of the interior really offers a lot of needs for a lot of different type of people.
Now, I don't see crossovers as being the typical sports car type of vehicle.
Right.
But you decided to put the sports shifters on the steering wheel for your sports trunk. Why'd you do that?
Well, that's something that's kind of uniquely Mitsubishi. If you look at kind of where Mitsubishi really excels, we really excel in kind of this SUV world. We have a real strong SUV DNA, and we've done very well in the Paris-Dakar rally. We've done very well in WRC. And that's kind of a technology or a racing that's combined fun to drive and handling dynamics with off-road capability as well. And that's really what this vehicle is all about, is that, again, sport utility. It's about sports. It's not just about utility. And just because you have a vehicle that's flexible and offers a lot of utility doesn't mean that it doesn't have to be fun to drive. So it really wants to be kind of a utility vehicle with the soul of a sports car.
Now, from the rear end with the new tail lights, the clear glass, I mean, the jewel appearance, how did you come up with that design?
Well, that's something that really we wanted to give the car a premium feel. And what that does is it gives the car a techie feel. Again, being a Japanese brand, people expect us to offer technology. And so, for example, the headlights offer HID as an option. And in the back, they have LED taillights. Very techie, very high tech. And people like that type. It's almost like what we in the design business call makeup and jewelry for the car. And giving a car a little bit of that really gives a lot of appeal to the customer.
And what's the biggest difference between the two trim levels?
Well, really, it's set up as far as the equipment level. The base trim level still is a nicely equipped car. It doesn't necessarily come with a navigation system. You can get the Rockford Fosgate system. But there's just a few little trim pieces. For example, when you move from the LS to the XLS, you get things like fog lamp, color key door handles, silver-colored accented roof rack, and then you can order the navigation system as well with the hard drive system. So it's a way that the customer can basically tailor the car to what they need and what they can afford.
And you have the fast key entry system. Is that something that the competition doesn't offer?
Yeah, some of the competition doesn't have that yet. It's really cool because all you have to do is have the key on your stead. So if it's in your pocket or in your purse, when you come up to the car, it senses that you have the key and will unlock the door for you. And what you can do is you can program it so that it unlocks just your side or the passenger side. And you can also start the car without a key. So it's just a nice convenience feature. And again, it's one of those nice techie details that really our customers are going to respond to.
Now, from a safety standpoint, have you gotten any feedback or has it gone through the NHTSA crash test yet for us?
Yeah, we're anticipating a 5-star crash rating on the car because it has a very rigid body to it. It has a lot of body reinforcements to it. And a lot of attention has been paid for side impact, the side curtain airbags, all those types of things. So we're anticipating very, very good safety ratings.
And from a pricing standpoint, what's the difference between pricing the two trim levels?
Well, the car, all the pricing hasn't been announced yet, but the vehicle is going to start at under 20. So if you look at some of the competition, well, there's some competition that's out there that's a full $10,000 more than what we're charging for the car. So it really offers a tremendous value story.
And when will it be available in the dealerships?
It will be in dealerships November of this year.
And what excites Dan about the new Outlander?
Well, you know, I like the way it looks. I like the flexibility. And what I like especially is the paddle shift. It's as close to the PlayStation as you can get in a real car, and it's a lot of fun.
Great, Dan. Thanks for taking the time.
Thank you.
This is Roosevelt Gist with Auto Network, and we're here in San Francisco with Mitsubishi for the launch of the new Outlander. And as always, please buckle up. Don't drink and drive. See you next time.
Thank you, sir. That was painless.